Welcome to our fifth edition of the Indian Hills School District's Technology Update. I'm Robert Reed, Technology Facilitator for the Indian Hill Middle and High Schools, and your host for today's presentation. Our topic for this session is on the new Electronic Media Center, or as many of us remember from the earlier days, the library. Our high school media center, as well as others in our district, has been through some dramatic technological changes within the last few years. Now here's a look at how new information technologies are used in our library of the future.
Changing today. Librarians are becoming information specialists. Today's libraries not only have traditional materials, such as books, magazines, and pamphlets, we also have CDs, microfiche, and databases to provide information for patrons. Most libraries today also have automated card catalogs to help patrons search for materials. In light of this, school libraries have recognized the need to teach students new ways of locating information. Now in our instruction with students, we not only teach how to use a print index such as Reader's Guide, we teach Boolean searching of magazine databases to get the exact information needed by the student. We feel this is very necessary to prepare students to find information in other libraries and obtain information from varied sources. Based upon today's technology, assignments for students are also changing. It is commonplace for students to do library research and not write a research paper. Instead, students can create a computer slide presentation using a product such as PowerPoint, containing sound and graphics as the culmination of their research. Students can scan pictures to include in their presentations. They download sound and motion video from CDs, Laserdiscs, and the internet. In addition, they can create their own original graphics using a paint program or an animation clip, using appropriate software, and include these in their presentations. In the Indian Hill School Library System, a fiber optic wiring system allows all students to search and check out materials from any of the four buildings. This ability starts the students thinking more globally when looking for information. This idea of resource sharing is then further fostered by the use of the internet and the school's membership in the Greater Cincinnati Library Consortium. The latter is a group of local, public, college, and special libraries who allow our students to borrow their materials free of charge. Since we have the college and public library card catalogs online in our library, it is simple for our students to search these libraries and call for the materials. Also, the GCLC group provides document delivery via fax directly to our library for our students. Internet access is offered to students for research purposes. The internet offers a virtual reference collection via the Indian Hill Library webpage. It provides access to bibliographic, abstract, and full-text information for all students. In addition to library computers, the Indian Hill Libraries also have class-sized computer labs adjacent to the library. The lab serves, again, as an internet, an email, and a word processing area for students. It serves as a production area for PowerPoint slide construction and an area for database research using network CDs such as ProQuest and SIRS. The lab is also equipped with curriculum-specific software for class use. Students at Indian Hill find that new technologies make their search for information easier. Finding desired information in today's society of information overload can be streamlined and simplified using today's new information technologies.
We have with us Mrs. Bev Oliver, Media Specialist Librarian for the Indian Hill High School. She's been instrumental in transforming our library into our facility to a true media center. Bev, welcome to our show. Now, in our introduction, you've emphasized the idea of researching in the new library. So you've been very instrumental in transforming this library into that kind of a facility. So how has it really changed in light of what's happened?
Well, thank you for inviting me. It'll be fun to talk about libraries, my favorite thing. The older libraries, of course, didn't have the technology that's been developed lately. Some of the school libraries still have trouble funding large portions of technology. Here at Indian Hill, we really are fortunate in having the facility and the wherewithal to obtain a lot of technology. the high school library, the middle school library, the elementary library, and the primary school library in Indian Hill. All four libraries have computerized card catalogs, which we can share. The older research that we did had to be with a card catalog that was paper cards. It was functional, but not nearly as nice as searching a database full of information or books. It's much easier for the students. Students of today are growing up with computers, so they're very computer literate and have no trouble at all utilizing the card catalog that's electronic versus the old paper one. Many of the reference sets that were available in libraries, the print sets, the hard copy magazines, all of those were so expensive that a lot of libraries that were small, and especially again school libraries, they just simply couldn't do that because they couldn't afford large print collections. And actually electronic media is much cheaper, so more and more schools can buy materials on CDs, buy materials on laser discs. And it's afforded a greater opportunity, I think, for today's kids in school libraries to actually obtain really valid information, obtain it quickly, and use it to produce some type of school assignment.
Now you work very closely with the teachers in those assignments. So how are those changes reflected in the different research procedures in the libraries now?
The assignments of today in our school system are becoming more and more electronically oriented. The teachers of today in Indian Hill have TV monitors in their room. They have a lot of equipment in their room. They have access in their teacher stations in each room to products like PowerPoint, so that many of our students now can produce a PowerPoint presentation in the library, which is a slideshow. They can add graphics to it. They can add sound to it, items like that. And they can then take that to the teacher station in the classroom and produce information as a result of their research. Rather than perhaps a paper. We of course still use books. We still emphasize the production of research papers. We definitely teach the students how to do that. But a lot of short-term today's assignments are electronically oriented. I had a student the other day in an English class who created a website as part of his presentation to drive home points that they had learned in reading To Kill a Mockingbird. And he actually constructed a temporary website. It was a very interactive learning experience for the kids in the class because he would contact an appropriate website to make a point with regard to that text and that reading. And the kids just loved it in the class. It was very interesting, very intriguing. And it's just another example of more and more electronic, especially short-term assignments that the kids are doing, rather than long, lengthy papers that have to be read and redrafted and things like that.
Well, obviously, along comes the idea of how do we go about training students in these new research methods. How do you approach that?
Right. The librarians in Indian Hill about 4 years ago worked on the development of a research grid, as we called it. And we, at that time, published what's called an Indian Hill Research Guide for the students. And within that guide, we have a research grid. And it's K through 12, and it tells all the students and the parents or anyone that wants one of these books exactly what our students will be doing at any one time and in the area of research. And we do what's called bibliographic instruction, which means that we do teach the kids how to do research. We teach them on all the electronic devices that we have. We do that in classes, and then we do it one-on-one. We really introduce it usually in a class, and then the kids that might not be as computer oriented as some of the others. We have the ones who are computer oriented help the others. And I have an assistant in my library, and she and I help them out. And so we do a lot of instruction one-on-one to help them out. The research guide helps focus each grade level, I think. And so the teachers all know what's going on, what the child is capable of at any grade level. They do small little papers in the primary school. But largely they do projects, you know, because they're smaller, littler children. And they enjoy the project portion of it. And as they grow up in their research, we demand more and more and lengthier papers. And then, as I say, now we're focusing on the electronic sources so that they can produce electronic presentations instead of just papers.
Seems like there is quite a bit that has really occurred in the technology area in our libraries. But What about, say, in the future? What do you see as the new technologies that perhaps will be developed and used?
There's a group within Cincinnati called the Greater Cincinnati Library Consortium that I mentioned in the overview that I did. And that's an area of great growth. The idea of utilizing global resources and sharing of information, number one, has been fostered by the internet recently. But the idea of resource sharing is really important, I think, and is ever growing. And I think as a future position, libraries are going to actually do collection assessment and see what they have, whether it is an electronic resource or whether it's a print resource. And they are going to do collection assessment and then share what they do have with other libraries. Actually, that's in the process now with the academic college libraries. They are going through their collections and have been for about 3 or 4 years and assessing what they have. Then they publish that information so that other people can use that. And I see more and more of that, for example, in the future. Because, again, print is sometimes expensive. Sometimes electronic databases are expensive. Speaking of databases, I see those being aimed at the web. The large library companies have already published web-based magazine databases, let's say. So the databases that we can buy now on CD, we can also now buy with web internet access. So fortunately in Indian Hill, we have a lot of internet access, and that will allow us to partake of those databases. The databases continue to grow. That's definitely an area in which children revel. They really enjoy using a database. The search is easy. The search gets you a lot of information really fast. It can be printed out in almost all cases, and the kids can take the information home and study it and work on it. The databases on the web will allow them access from home as well. And they'll not only be able to, you know, utilize things in school libraries or public libraries, but then they can sit if they have an internet connection at home and do their research there. I'm part of a test group through the Kenton County Public Library right now, and they are allowing our students to use Vista, which is a magazine database test site, and it does have full-text magazines, and our kids can access those and print those out and use them. So again, it goes back to resource sharing, and it goes back to electronic databases. Those are both fields that will grow, I think, in the future. In our own library, I'm anxious to use what's called a recordable CD, because our kids are becoming so talented at doing PowerPoint presentations, and they tend to, oftentimes there'll be a simplistic subject in nature. In order to learn the process, we have a course here in computer applications where the kids will use a process to develop a nice multimedia presentation using PowerPoint. And then my goal is to record those PowerPoint presentations onto a CD and record several of them on a recordable CD and then send those presentations down to the lower schools so that they can use them in little workstations down there, because a lot of times it'll be on a basic science subject like frogs or dogs or maybe on ballet or football, and so those little kids can actually benefit and get information from that, because our older students are definitely putting a lot into those presentations, and I hate to lose those, you know, by cleaning a hard drive every year, so I'm anxious to record those on CD and send those down to the lower schools where they can use them. Another thing that I'm interested in is a field called media retrieval. While we do have a lot of VCRs and we have a lot of machinery in the classroom, I think that the idea of having it controlled by the individual teacher in a media retrieval system is really important. I think that that way they can show a video clip for 2 minutes of a sea anemone or something like that, and then they can cut that off. They have control. The media retrieval can be sent out from the library, but yet the teacher has individual control in the room, and I think that's important. So I'm looking forward to either that or the digital voice data system that we might employ to allow the kids to receive media in the classroom.
Okay.
That's about it, I guess.
Well, it sounds like there are just so many things and many areas in the future in which our students will be working as they do their various research projects. But I'd like to thank you for joining us today in our presentation. Today's Media Center is certainly different than libraries a few years ago. But before we leave today, we'd like to inform you of a change in our Open Computer Lab. Open Computer Lab will now be available only on Wednesdays from 6 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. for the remainder of the school year. Open Computer Lab is an opportunity for any student, parent, or other community resident to utilize the computer lab equipment and software. Now, a lab supervisor will be available to offer assistance when needed. Our final Cyber Studio course offerings for the second semester are coming up soon. Now, they are presentations with PowerPoint that will be going from May 5th through the 8th in the high school lab one, room 124. And one of our new offerings, Parents as Partners, using multimedia tools, is from May 12th to the 15th in the primary school lab. Now, each class is a 90-minute session beginning at 7 p.m. and is conducted for a total of four times from Monday through Thursday during the scheduled week. It's easy to reserve a seat. Just call our Cyber Studio hotline at 272-4591 and press 2. Leave your name, correct spelling of your name, address, phone number, course or courses requested, and your preferred date. After that, we'll confirm your registration by letter. If you wish to speak with a technology facilitator or have questions, please include that in your message. Your call will be returned as promptly as possible. Now, if you've enjoyed this edition of our technology update program, be sure to look for future presentations. Each month, a new technology-related topic will be presented on some current aspect of educational technology in the Indian Hill Exempted Village School District. For program times, you can call the ICRC at 272-4272. And this concludes our fifth edition of the Indian Hill Schools Technology Update. Special thanks to all of our staff and students on both sides of the camera for making this presentation possible. See you next time, and have a great day.